In a previous video, we mentioned that just training your glutes won't be enough in most cases to treat a runner with iliotibial band syndrome. But if glute training is not enough, what should we do then? In this video, we will present a rehab program for ITBS.
Enroll in our online course now. Link is in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. So before we discuss what you can do to rehab ITBS, let's first look at what you shouldn't do. As the ITB cannot lengthen, stretching is not a useful treatment option. Neither is foam rolling, which, contrary to popular belief, does not release or break down adhesions. Given that ITBS is probably a compression injury, these two treatments might actually make matters worse. So what should we do instead? When it comes to rehab for runners, we will have to focus on the following three main components, which were proposed by Willie and Mara in 2016. These are 1. Peak loads, which will be addressed by heavy slow resistance training. 2. Energy storage and release, which we will train with plyometric exercises. And 3. Cumulative loads, which will be addressed by a graded return to running, including running retraining. Our colleague Tom Goom has suggested the following 5 stages to progress ITB rehab in runners, which includes the 3 main components of rehab as well. Stage 1, the pain-dominant phase. The goal is to decrease irritability without sacrificing capacity. How do you know that your patient is in stage 1? These are patients that have often ceased running completely and who experience pain when descending stairs and with fast walking. In this phase, the patient should reduce excessive overload by activities that further provoke the ITB. At the same time, we do not want complete cessation of activities and keep the general activity level as high as possible. In concrete, a patient should cease running, especially trail or downhill running, but switch over to fast treadmill walking with an inclination angle of around 8 to 10 degrees. If this is not possible, the patient should explore if cycling with a low saddle or swimming are pain-free alternatives. The following exercises are low-load options that focus on strengthening of the hip, abductors, and extensors. Load dominant phase. The load dominant phase is entered as soon as the patient is able to descend stairs pain-free. Stage 2, heavy slow resistance training to address peak loads during running. Patients then enter stage 2, which mainly focuses on heavy slow resistance training. While uphill treadmill walking is continued, the exercises from stage 1 are further progressed. These heavy slow resistance exercises should be performed 3 times a week until return to running is achieved in stage 5. The same is true for uphill treadmill walking, which can be ceased as soon as running can be resumed. Stage 3, plyometrics to address energy storage and release during running. When rehabbing a patient with ITBS, it's important to realize that the ITB acts similar like a tendon in a way that it stores and releases energy during running, like mentioned in a study of Eng et al. In the year 2015. For this reason, we will have to train the ITB's function to deal with energy storage and release activities without the cumulative loads we get from running. The fact that the ITB works like a tendon should also make us wonder why many approaches are trying to decrease stiffness and lengthen the ITB. If there's only one thing we know of tendons, then it's that they need to be stiff to be as efficient like a spring, and lengthening like in Achilles tendon ruptures renders them inefficient. To confirm this, a study by Fried et al. In the year 2020 has shown that physiotherapy improved outcomes in patients with ITBS and actually increased ITB stiffness by 14%. Now let's look at examples of plyometric exercises progressed from easy to more advanced. Stage 3 is used as a rather short bridge from stage 2 to stage 4, usually lasting for a week. Stage 4, return to level running and gait retraining. As soon as stage 4 is entered, the plyometric exercises are phased out in the second and third week. Running should be reintroduced in a graded manner. To give you a concrete plan on how to build up running, we have attached the From the Couch to 5K running plan in the description that you can download for free. This PDF is one of many useful documents from our Running Rehab online course. A good idea is to gradually lower the inclination angle of the treadmill from 8 to 10 degrees to about 5 degrees until the runner is able to run on level ground or outside again. There are a couple of biomechanical factors that can be targeted by mirror retraining. Be aware though that gait modifications should be specific to the runner in front of you and don't apply to every case. First, increase step width. While crossover gait usually puts more strain on the ITB, running with a wider gait reduces compression. You can train this by giving the patient cues like "don't cross over the line" after you have drawn a line with chalk in the middle of the treadmill. Second, increase the knee window. This means that there is usually space between the knees when you analyze their running pattern from a posterior view. A cue to achieve a bigger knee window could be to tell your patient, "don't let your knees kiss," or you could put some tape on the outside of both knees and tell the patient to push the markers apart. If the patient presents with a pelvic drop, also called Trendelenburg sign, you could put markers on the iliac crest and cue them to keep the markers level. Third, increase cadence. Increasing cadence by about 5 to 10%, which can be achieved by a metronome, for example, reduces peak load on the knee as well as peak hip adduction. Running retraining is especially important as a study of Willey et al. In the year 2012 has shown that glute strengthening does not change running mechanics. In the same study, they confirmed, however, that mirror gait retraining is effective for improving running mechanics. And finally, stage 5, return to downhill running and trail running. In his last stage 5, the runner should gradually increase his training volume. Trail and downhill running can be gradually added on separate days before they are combined in a single session. Okay, so first of all, a quick shout out to running experts Rich Willey, Tom Goom, and Benno Matthew for valuable input for this video. If you haven't watched our ITB myth busting video, check it out by a click right next to me. If we could get you a little bit excited about running injuries, you should go and check out our online course on running rehab from pain to performance with running experts and lower limb experts Benno and Matthew. You can find more info in the description below this video. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in another video. Bye.